If you drive a little way from Pierce, South Dakota, you'll find the Dakota Lakes Research Farm. But if you're looking for people in lab coats, you'll be disappointed because the researchers are out in the field. I spent a couple of days with Dr. Dwayne Beck, the farm's manager, who walked me through some of the philosophies Dakota Lakes has implemented since 1990.
In a systems approach, we're using basic ecology principles to try to decide how things work. And that comes down to why you look at the native vegetation first. And that tells you what you can do where you're at, but to use Mother Nature's system. It's an approach of trying to fit in with what the system's gonna allow you to do rather than trying to make the system do what you want it to do. I mean, the idea is how close can we get to mimicking the natural ecosystem in terms of how we cycle the nutrients, how we harvest the sunlight, how we cycle the water. Living soil is one of the things that's on the sign. The outcomes are what we're really looking for. We can't get to that outcome with no-till alone. We can't get to that outcome with cover crops alone. We can't get to that outcome, in my opinion, with rotations that aren't diverse, which everybody wants to do, because, you know, I'm a corn grower. Well, I'm a corn grower too, and I grow wheat, and I grow teff, and I grow peas, and I grow lentils, and I grow flax, and I grow soybeans, and I grow sunflowers, and right? We do all those things. And I have some perennials. And we can still keep high percentages if we think corn, like under irrigation, corn's a good thing. We keep a high percentage of corn in the rotation, but we're throwing this other stuff in there just to mix it up. And it makes the corn better and much cheaper to grow. The point is as farmers, the diversity gives you lots of advantages, economic advantages that you don't necessarily see unless you're doing them, because they save you all this money if you figure out how to take advantage of the system.